Welcome to Drama Class. I'm Miss Cindy Loa, and I'm so glad to have you in my class. Today, you're going to learn how to answer two very important questions. What is acting, and how do you live truthfully under imaginary circumstances when you are acting? Let's get started by warming up our bodies. This is important because, as actors, we have three instruments that we use to act: our body, our voice, and our mind. Just like a musician plays an instrument, like a drum or a piano, we play our character using our body, mind, and voice as our instruments to tell a story. So let's warm up our instruments so we are ready to move creatively and quickly in the moment. Tongue twisters are a fun part of any warm-up. They give us the chance to practice our articulation, which is the act of speaking sounds and syllables clearly. Let's learn our tongue twister. You're going to repeat after me. The big black bug bit the big brown bear. And the big brown bear bled badly. But he didn't bleed blue blood. Now that we've warmed up our bodies, let's warm up our minds by thinking about a very important question. What is acting? A great acting coach named Sanford Meisner says that acting is to live truthfully under imaginary circumstances. We could also say it's stepping into the shoes of a character, feeling what they are feeling, and doing what they would do under specific circumstances. Living implies that we must think about real life when we are acting. In real life, we react with our body, face, and voice to circumstances and events depending on how we feel and our emotions. For example, what if you got a good grade on a test you thought you might have failed? How would you respond? It may sound easy, but when you get on stage in front of a large audience, it's not so easy to show emotion truthfully. So let's practice expressing different emotions so that you can feel confident when you need to express them while acting in a scene. For the first example, I'll show you how I would express the emotion with my face, eyes, and body language, and I want you to express it too, in your own way, as if you are feeling that same emotion. Here we go. Here's jealous. Okay, now you show me jealous. 3, 2, 1, freeze. If you're in a group, glance around the room. Is their expression realistic? Okay, you can relax. Hey guys, thanks for joining me. It's time to do a little bit of performing. Together, we are going to create emotion machines. Machines have a lot of different parts that work together. Parts that pull and push, lift and lower, give and take. Now let's start with AJ. AJ, would you like to start our machine? Add on. Fabulous. And Megan, add the next part of our machine. Awesome choice. And Christina, go ahead and add on the last part of our machine. Wow, very creative. Nice work. Let's try a love machine. There are so many ways we can represent the feeling of love. I'll start. If my friend gave me a birthday card, I would feel loved. Oh, how sweet. I would keep repeating the motion over and over again. How sweet. Who would like to add on? All right. How sweet.
I love you.
How sweet.
I love you.
Aww. All right. Nice job. I definitely felt the love. In today's extension activity, you can create some emotion machines with your group. There are many emotions you can use. Feel free to come up with more types of emotion machines on your own. Have fun with it. I know you'll do great.